I'd like to share some of the practicalities in practicing Reiki professionally. For some of you who are knowledgeable about business and everything, please forgive me if I talk about things that are obvious to you. But some people have never ever set up business on their own before. The first issue we should look at is the exchange of energy involved in the therapeutic contact. Most of the time, this takes the form of money. Some practitioners do not charge, and this is fine, as everybody has the right to charge whatever they want, or to charge nothing at all. However, it is often a far better cause and balanced energy exchange if the client is able to give something in return for the Reiki treatment. Remember, the client is not paying for the energy, as we mentioned earlier, which is free, but for your time and the effort you have put into learning and paying for your Reiki training. When people receive treatment for free, they often feel indebted to the therapist and feel guilty as a result. This situation can create an imbalance, leaving an unresolved situation which can get in the way of the continued treatments. So charging money allows people the freedom to come and go whenever they want, when it feels appropriate. You can charge some people less or even barter. Many practitioners regularly allow a couple of reduced Reiki places so that people who need Reiki but cannot afford the normal prices may benefit and receive treatments in this way. It is important to keep the balance so that not all of your sessions are reduced. If it was all reduced sessions, it could leave you feeling drained and even resentful, which in the long run is not beneficial to your clients. I have discussed this subject several times, but it comes down to a matter of respecting and valuing yourself. How much should you charge for a Reiki session? It's a good idea to find out how much other practitioners are charging in the area, so your fees are not too different from theirs. If there is no other Reiki healer living near to you, find out how much people charge for massage or reflexology treatments. A Reiki session will last about 45 minutes to 1 hour. When you first start charging for your sessions, you can start by charging a slightly lower rate if that feels comfortable to you. And then as your reputation spreads and your confidence develops, you could increase your fee. I personally feel it's easier to charge your true rate from the start of your practice, which perhaps with perhaps an introductory offer of, say, 3 treatments for the price of 2. The other thing you'll need to consider are promotional aids. So business cards are a very first step to starting your practice. You can get business cards quite reasonably priced at addresses we've mentioned in our manual. And they just normally charge you a fee for postage and packing. Buy them on the internet. They make it easier to give people your telephone number when you want to make an appointment. You can also use them as appointment cards and write the time and date on the back of the card. It is a very good idea to talk to people first before setting up an appointment to get a feel about their energy and to let them know what they can expect from the Reiki session. Remember that people all have different concepts and expectations about what they are going to receive, with some people having funny ideas about therapy also. Although you may be enthusiastic, use your wisdom and discrimination in relation to accepting your new clients. Especially if you're a female, it's a good idea to have another person in the building when you're working with a new client for the first time, for your own security and peace of mind. Explaining the treatment first inspires confidence and will often reassure potential clients if they do not know much about Reiki. Depending on how you intend to work and offer Reiki to others, a promotional leaflet is also a good idea. The other thing you will need to do is keep client records, and in your manual you'll discover that we've listed lots and lots of forms, lots and lots of administration aids, if you like, to help you run your practice smoothly. So when you make appointments, obtain your client's name, address and phone number, as this will start your database, which of course will be also useful for future mailings and your marketing purposes. Because as your database grows, you can then send out flyers, Christmas cards, birthday cards. You never know what you might get involved with in the future in terms of workshops, etc. So a mailing list can become very important for you. You can use a client information form at the beginning of your Reiki treatment when starting treatments for a new client. It can also be a good idea to ask your client to sign a disclaimer form explaining that Reiki, what Reiki is and what Reiki is not, and that it's a complementary therapy. For example, it can state that Reiki is not science of disease or a substitute for medical, psychological diagnosis or treatment. It can state that Reiki is a relaxation technique and a hands-on healing technique that can promote well-being and seeks to stimulate the client's natural healing resources. You can add that Reiki practitioners do not infer with any other treatments the client may be receiving, but rather seeks to interact and complement conventional medicine and other natural therapies. So again, all our forms in the manual will help you do this. Another thing you'll need to consider then is promoting your practice. One way to let people know about your Reiki practice is to offer exchange treatments with other therapists. This spreads the word. You could also refer clients to them and ask them to do the same to you. You can ask other therapists if you can leave some of your cards or leaflets with them. One of the most successful ways in getting in touch with yourself and getting started, of course, is to talk to a lot of people about what you do. Talk at parties, talk at any kind of social gatherings, talk to your friends. Many people have heard about Reiki, might not know what it is. Do radiate enthusiasm. However, if you detect a glazed look on the other person's face, please stop talking. Because if people are not interested, accept it. And as they say, let go and move on. Offering free treatments can be a rewarding way to get started and build up your confidence. This is very good way of getting your work known. So you can do this by not appearing to give it away particularly, but as an introductory free session. And then when the person's experienced how enjoyable receiving Reiki is, they may book again. But at least they've had the good experience. And then you can start charging your normal fee. Always have your business cards with you. So another thing you can do is give a talk to a group of friends or to clubs, societies. Prepare a talk before you start. A standard holistic fare can be expensive, but often therapists are happy to share space and costs. When people make an inquiry with you, always get their names and address and telephone number for your mailing list. You can offer short 20-minute treatments for a fee of, say, £5 or £8 as an introduction to experiencing Reiki. You can volunteer to offer free Reiki treatments at hospitals, hospices, cancer support groups, etc. This may not be a way of getting paying clients, obviously, but it will generate a lot of knowledge about you, and people talk to other people. Always remember to leave your business cards and your leaflets wherever you go. You can also write an article for the local newspaper. And if you're feeling extremely confident, you can offer a talk on the radio or even a television program. So do not be shy about sharing your gift of Reiki. Do not think of promoting your work as selling yourself, which has negative connotations. Rather, think of all the benefits and blessings that people can experience when they receive a Reiki treatment. Share your experience and dedication with others with enthusiasm. This will be very contagious. Remember, you are supported fully and totally by the universal beloved divine consciousness. Thank you very much and enjoy your practice.